name is Karen O'Rourke and I'm Curator of Social History at the Museum of Liverpool.
What's the significance to Liverpool of the Liverpool Overhead Railway?
Well, I suppose the main significance is it's the last one of its type surviving in the world, the carriage. The railway was innovative of the time and certainly indicative of the way that the people of Liverpool and the businessmen, prominent businessmen of Liverpool, felt about the city. This city was the second city of the empire. Disraeli said that, and I think that the buildings and the structures reflect that.
What was the purpose of the railway?
Well, the purpose of the railway was to get people from one end of the docks to the other. There were 6.5 miles of docks. The horse buses that were running at the time could take anything up to an hour and a quarter to travel that length. The overhead railway did it in 25 minutes.
And what sort of people used it?
Initially, it was built to get messengers along the docks, not cargo specifically, but certainly people from A to B. After a while, they realised that the Liverpool Overhead Railway Company realised that this was a marketable trip for tourists, and so they would market it for tourists. They extended the railway a few years after it was built to reach out to the suburbs on both the north and south end of the city, because they were, after 6 p.m. the railway was virtually unused, and once they'd opened it out to the suburbs it became much, much busier. But the purpose was to get anybody from one end of the dock to the other, to either tourist or dock worker.
60 years later, why do you think it's held in such affection still?
I think, well, it was such a prominent feature on the waterfront. You know, there are still areas of the waterfront where you can see the supporting columns. And I think that people's memories, a lot of people were taken on as children to see the waterfront and to see the working docks. And most of the people still surviving who remember it, remember going on as children. So it's one of their earliest childhood memories.
And what's the significance of today? How is the coach going to be displayed?
Well, it's our first object to come into the museum, which is fantastic. You know, we've been building up to this for a very long time. We've watched the building go up, and now to bring the first object in, it feels like the project's really moving ahead. It will be displayed in the middle floor, which is where you can see the glass windows, and it will be displayed in such a way that the visitor can view it from below, sitting on a mock-up of the track. So it will be approximately 16 feet above the ground, give or take a foot or two. But the visitor can also go up onto the first floor level and can get onto the railway carriage and can view the carriage from the inside. They can't walk up and down the carriage because we have to be very aware that this is the last one of its type in the world. But they can get on and have a look at the carriage. And they can also listen to stories of people who travelled on the railway, their own memories.
Thank you very much. Thanks for your time.
No problem.
Charlie!
Important part of the city's history.
Well, the Liverpool Overhead Railway ran from 1893 to the 1950s, and it was really an essential part of the dock traffic system, taking workers and messengers all the way along the docks. It's much beloved by people. It's held in fond affections, and we have a lot of people who still remember it being in action and travelling on it today.
And how important is this going to be as part of the attractions at the new Liverpool Museum?
Well, it's one of our key exhibits. We've designed the museum especially so that it fits in. It's going to be displayed at the height it would have been when you travelled on it originally, so it's being suspended on a platform above one of the galleries, and it's really going to be really one of the key attractions in the museum.
Tell us a bit about the operation to bring it out of storage and down to the museum. It's not been easy.
It's a delicate operation. I mean, it's been years in the planning. We've years of conservation work and engineering calculations and all sorts of risk assessments. So yes, it's been a long operation. So this is a great day for us to finally get it done.
What was going through your head as it was coming up the ramps onto the lorry here?
Actually, an immense sense of relief. I'm just delighted to see it going so smoothly.
What is it about the overhead railway and the objects like this? What is it you think that gets to people, that makes them so popular and people remember them so fondly?
It's a difficult one. Transport is always held in great affection by people, and I think it's got a sort of romance of a real sense of the past to it.